Picture yourself cruising on a boat on a river. Not just any river, a scenic European waterway winding its way past open pastures, ancient castles and enchanting villages. Not just any boat, an elegant Tauk riverboat that is your luxurious hotel as you explore the old world. We will look after your every need. Virtually every expense is included in one upfront price. Want to get in the picture? At Expedia Cruise Ship Centers, we take your travels to a new level.
Always exciting to talk about travel, great opportunities in the travel field these days, and Chris Meyer back with us today to talk about his company, Expedia Cruise Ship Centers, right here in Saddleback Valley. Chris, welcome back to you.
Great to be back, Rob.
Good to have you with us. You brought along a special guest today.
Yeah, this is Nancy Ecker from Tauk Tours.
Nancy, good to have you with us. Thanks for coming by on the program today. So, Tauk Tours, we kind of think of you folks as sort of an all-inclusive package, correct?
That's absolutely correct. We have tours all over the world. Today we're going to be talking about river cruising, but we offer everything from African safaris, small ship, fully escorted tours, and our river cruising, which is the fastest growing segment of European travel.
You know, I've heard a lot about that. And Chris, I know that everybody says, you know, river cruising, they think of these gigantic cruise ships. It's a specially built craft just for river cruising.
Yeah, they're a long, narrow craft to go down the river, hold usually about 150 people. And they're traveling down the ancient highways of Europe. So when they pull into town, they're in the center of town. You walk off the ship and there's the cathedral over there. Mm-hmm. There's the old castle.
Yeah, it sounds exciting indeed. Now, of course, by having an all-inclusive package like you folks provide, people really don't have a lot of problems with trying to figure out, now, let's see, what package will I take when I get off the ship in this town? You pretty much have it all planned out for everybody.
That's correct. It's an all-inclusive. It's one price, so they know up front what they're paying. All their gratuities, all of their round trip, airport transfers are included. All their excursions are included, meals. We do wine and beer and soft drinks complimentary with all lunch and dinners. So it's fully inclusive, and they get to enjoy the experience without being nickel and dimed along the way.
Right. And I know for a lot of people, since they've never been to that town or that city or that river even maybe, knowing which package tour to take, which castle to tour, which cathedral to see, is a rough decision because they really have never been there unless they've done a lot of homework. You've really done the homework for them, not only with the places to visit, but the people to show them the places.
That's correct. And we have beautiful brochures that Chris and his staff can work with our collateral that we have, and they can look and see where they may want to go, where they have looked to go, maybe they're revisiting something. But as Chris said, it's the original waterways. The roads along there will take you to places that you've never seen before.
Right. And I understand that because of the rivers being the original highways, people would build their homes. That was the view, was the river. And so the nice part of the house is the front. If you're there on a bus, you're going to go by the trash cans in the service entrance, I guess.
Well, it's a pretty nice experience.
Still from a castle, it's still nice, but yeah.
It's still nice, but it's a pretty nice experience to be on top of a boat as it's sailing down the river and eating lunch and watching the castles and the vineyards go by and the storybook.
Obviously, a great package and a great opportunity. Where are some of the places that you provide river cruising?
We have the French waterways. We have the Rhine, the Main, the Danube. We also have places in Egypt along the Nile, and we also have the Yangtze River, but we have many more there in the European River.
Yeah. Well, I guess they sort of perfected it. All those other countries did it as well. If someone's never been on a river cruise, maybe both of you, make a suggestion. What would be a first one that somebody might want to consider?
I think the Blue Danube is usually one of the first ones. It's very scenic. It's very beautiful. The little towns and communities along there are something that everybody really enjoy and appreciate. Mm-hmm. The French waterways, of course, with all the fabulous chateaus and the wineries and that the Epicurean experience is very popular.
I understand that although you're using the boats to get around, you don't stay on the boat the whole time. You do have a chance to get off and see the towns, correct?
See them, and Tauk's destination specialists are renowned for giving you insight into the culture.
Mm-hmm. You know, you can read about it in a book and maybe know a little bit about something, but if you're with somebody who knows that area, who's traveled there before, obviously they've got insights that we can't have.
Absolutely. We hire local guides. We have four onboard TALC directors that are there helping everybody with their needs onboard the ship. Once they step off, three of the four go into the destinations, but we have local guides that know those regions and take them into the towns and the experiences there.
Sounds great. So, and then again, at night, you don't have to worry about, gee, where are we going to stay tonight, because your room is there on the boat.
Not only that, but instead of making the 8-hour drive like I've done through Europe from place to place, you're sleeping and having dinner while you're getting from place to place.
So in the morning you wake up and the boat's anchored someplace in some new city in some new little town or big town, and you have a new experience ahead of you. Sounds like an exciting way and a very relaxing way to travel as well. What about the cabins? What kind of facilities on board ship do we have?
We have only 118 passengers, so that allows us to have larger staterooms. And so our largest are 300 square foot, and our smallest is 150. Mm-hmm. So we have a wide variety of different sizes, and we have French balconies, floor-to-ceiling sliders that Great. They can enjoy the waterways.
So if you're cruising in late afternoon, early evening hours, still light out, you can enjoy the scenery as you float by.
Absolutely. Oh,
yes. Sounds like a great way to travel indeed. Well, you mentioned complimentary beverages at lunch and dinner. What about the food? Obviously, you know, people are interested in maybe having a culinary experience as well as a travel experience.
We have two restaurants on board. So we have one that the dining, it's open seating. So they have many, many different stations of food. They can order off the menu. So that is all complimentary. It's included. And then we have a little bistro at the back of the ship. And that is a set menu, but it's always the local cuisine. So if great. You're in France, they're going to have the French cuisine.
So. That's great. So a chance again to try what the locals enjoy and prepared right there for you on board ship. Chris, it sounds like some great opportunities there, and again, people can talk to you about some specifics, and you can give them a variety of the various talk tours available.
Yeah, really what our role is to have a conversation about what's important to the guest about their trip, and to help put it together in a way that would be most satisfying to them.
And obviously, by being all-inclusive, I guess you can even include the airfare in the package as well, correct? It gets them to the location, somebody's there with a sign, gets them on the bus, gets them to the boat, gets their luggage on board, and then they're on. What are the length of the typical cruises? Do they vary in length from wind to wind?
The shortest is 7, and we have the longest 24 days. So mm-hmm. yes, there's a variety, but a lot of people tend to, if they're going to go to Europe, they like to stay for 2 weeks. So we have many that are in that 11 to 15 day departures. Okay.
And obviously, depending on where you are in the world, seasonal changes, but time of the year, what, spring and summer primarily?
Right. We just started in April, so right now we have the Floriade that's taking place, and that just began in April, and it will go through the Christmas markets in December. Okay. So we have a lot of people that like to go back and enjoy the Christmas markets. It's chilly, but it is a lot of fun.
That sounds like a neat experience as well, and a lot of people have seen Europe in the summertime. That might be a different take, and I would imagine the decorations and the shopping opportunities and all that. And again, because you're traveling with your hotel, it's not that hard to get your items back and get them home after you end the cruise. So it sounds like a great pre-Christmas shopping experience as well, if you want to do a little bit of that. Well, Chris, when are you open over there? When can people come by and talk with you about these things?
Well, we're open Monday through Saturday, 9 to 6, and people can come in when they want, or they can make an appointment. We can give them even a little homework to research a few things online before they come. But what we want to do is just provide that door-to-door experience, cut mm-hmm. through the clutter. We have an overwhelming supply of travel opportunities, which is really great, but it can be confounding as well. And what we try to do is work with you to cut the clutter and give you an experience from the time you leave your door to the time you come back.
A world of choices, so to speak.
Oh,
that's
yeah.
great. I always like to ask our travel agency or travel representatives from companies, where do you like to travel?
I love Europe, and I have done FIT on my own. I've done traditional cruising, and I've done two river cruising in the last 2 years. Mm-hmm. That is my new love, is the river cruising experience.
Where's your next trip going to be?
Well, I just got back from Cuba, and
Cuba. We have to talk about that sometime.
I just got back from Cuba, and next month I'm going on a Ken Burns Civil War event that's in Washington, D.C.
Wow, a lot of exciting opportunities. Well, if you want to go in on an exciting travel opportunity, think about TALC Tours, all-inclusive, some great opportunities there. And talk to Chris real quick. Your office is located nearby?
Right near Trader Joe's, over in the Oak Brook Village Center. We're between Trader Joe's and Woody's Diner.
Super. Thank you both for joining us. Good to have you with us.
Thank you. Thank you.
It's getting excited about thinking about some of those travel opportunities myself. Get Mrs. Merritt to sit down and get the books out and start figuring where we're going to go on our next trip. We'll be coming right back with more as our program for today continues for you right here on Channel 6 TV.
Picture yourself cruising on a boat, on a river. Not just any river, a scenic European waterway winding its way past open pastures, ancient castles, and enchanting villages. Not just any boat, an elegant Tauk riverboat that is your luxurious hotel as you explore the old world. We will look after your every need. Virtually every expense is included in one upfront price. Want to get in the picture? At Expedia Cruise Ship Centers, we take your travels to a new level.